very useful presentation. Here the last paper of the session today by Mr. Sanjay Awasthi is present to study and do the research subjects in very engineering. Mr. Awasthi is both graduate in Robert Theology and Masters in Production Management. He has been there with us for the last 31 years, published over 100 papers nationally as well as internationally. The presentation is titled Diversification in Biofoods and Byproducts in Biofoods.
Honorary Minister, Mr. Kupesa, respected Chairman, and fellow delegates. Again, I must appreciate the presentation of Dr. Jose, which was a blockbuster of Mary Goldmeyer, Universal Studios kind of presentation. A short introduction that SJ is an 87 years old company having business in 90 countries and turnover of $800 million. We do everything and anything of sugar. Coming back to my presentation, this is basically regarding the diversification through biofuels and byproducts in biorefineries. Nowadays we are seeing that not only in India but all over the world, sugar is a major commodity. And still having a backbone of economy, still owners and sugar producers are having a lot of farmers areas, and they are not able to pay the areas on time. So we have to think out of the box, see how the industry can earn more revenue instead of only sugar or few byproducts. So in this presentation, basically I have covered about that. What is the potential of sugarcane and what is practically possible and is happening in some factories of India as well as rest part of the world. As we know that cane is giving us two main products. One is coal, which is having sugar, and the other one is fiber, beside non-sugars and water. So what we can have is some byproducts of bagan, and beside sugar we can have some byproducts through molasses and filter cake. So in this biorefinery chart, we try to show that what we can have out of sugar cane. We can produce bagasse, some byproducts from bagasse as well as power for export. We can produce farmer sugar, we can produce refined sugar, we can produce multiple type of sugar, liquid sugar. Similarly, we can also have CO2 while producing ethanol, which can go to the breweries, and power from the slop. And achieving zero liquid discharge, not taking any water for these factories. And these are the factories which are running in India on this model. So challenges faced by our industry may be that out of 732 proper registered factory, we have 525 only which are running. 276 are running with cogeneration and 50 are running with refined sugar. And we have 177 distilleries associated with these factories. The biggest challenge with us is that because we are producing more sugar, the more is scarcity, and from 36, with all support of the government and other bodies, still sugar price has come down to 31, whereas cane price on the year when sugar price was 36 rupees, from 290 it has gone up to 325. So it's an issue how to pay to farmers. And cane price is increasing and our final product price is decreasing. So major challenges at this moment, not only political and economical, which was always there, now environment is also has taken a main seat, and government has made it mandatory that factories should have minimum emission levels, and also there should not be, you know, any discharge. There has to be zero liquid discharge from the factories. This year, the farmers got the arrear touched to 20,000 crores in February 2019, which has been significantly paid, I believe, but still some arrears are there. And for sustainability, we have to find solutions that what are the other streams so that we can be benefited and have more revenue. Government is also having, you know, vision that by 2022, farmers should double their income. So we cannot ask for reducing the cane price also. What we have to see in this scenario that we have to do some alteration in this pattern, what is shown on this screen at this moment, that the carryovers every year is increasing. By far exception was only 17 and 18. So this year we are having almost 50% of consumption, which was in our hand and in our godowns when we started our season. So we have to see what we can do. The government has given a very good biofuel policy, but at the same time, we are having another challenge with us that most of the states are becoming surplus in power. We are probably at this moment is not the largest, but one of the largest power producer out of solar. Wind is also another thing by which a lot of power is coming. So the states are becoming surplus in power, and hence the price, which was 6.50 rupees not long back, has been reduced to 4.25 in Maharashtra, and even some states are struggling at 3 rupees per unit. So on this rate, it is merely viable to do, you know, co-generation, and even there is no guarantee if you put up a co-generation today, tomorrow government is going to honor that power purchase agreement or not. If the power is surplus, where they will take power? So we have to see some diversification, and that is what this paper is all about. We are talking that sugar, don't think of only making plantation white sugar or refined sugar only. Think of multiple products out of it which can increase your revenue. Pharma, like that, flavored sugar, cubes, candy, liquid sugar, khansari, jaggery. Similarly, from bagasse, we have to think for electricity, beside electricity, 2G ethanol, apparel fabric, perfurol, bioplastic bottles, paper industry, and cutlery. These all things are happening. There is nothing which is new. Again, like Dr. Jose, I am trying to put up all technologies which are available in the country to see if we can have put in one complex only. From molasses also, ENA, fuel, ethanol, these things are we are making, but we have to think of butanol, acetone, acetic acid, lactic acid, glycerol, ethylene. For example, VAM Organics in UP, there are so many other factories also which are making these products, but not in the same complexes. And from filter cake, bio-CNG, manure we are making in so many factories. Bio-CNG is a new thing which is happening in few factories, has to be adopted almost in each and every factory, because there is a huge potential which we will discuss in this presentation. With rising consciousness towards the premium sugar market, this can be shown through simple three, this, the public distribution system. Normal sugar is 31 rupees, which is fixed by the government. Refined sugar sells at least 150 to 200 rupees per bag premium at 33. And whereas pharma sugar as high as 42. And I have seen few invoices from some factories where we put up the pharma sugar that it has been taken at 70 and 65 rupees also. So there is a huge potential of earning revenue through these things. Some of the sugars and uses of these, we have brought it down here, that where your pharma kind of sugar can go, where your pharmaceutical grade sugar can go, where your refined sugar cubes generally use, and where icing. Now urbanization is at peak. Every day new malls, new hotels are being added. So the uses of these all things are increasing. Whereas hardly out of 525 factories, if I am correct, 4, 5, 6 are making these kind of products. Government has done a bit, not only by giving you 31 rupees fixed price of sugar, otherwise it could have gone to 20 rupees if not less. And the second good thing is biofuel policy. The EBP for 2018 and 2019, which is amendment being given by the government, the prices of final molasses, if produced, ethanol is produced through final molasses, 43.75, if B heavy, 54.27, and cane use 59.48. Beside this such a good rate, there is hardly one or two factories which came from juice to ethanol. B heavy, there are several, but we should be thinking that if we are having half of the production already in our godowns, why not to divert more and more juice for the ethanol? Why not to make divert B heavy? By diverting B heavy and juice, you have double advantage, because your power consumption will come down, you will be able to export more power, and your sugar quality will automatically improve if you are not making C sugar. So that C double cured, or some factories sending C single cured to the A boiling, that will not go back, and you will have better color of sugar automatically. The blending which government is at this moment, E10 program is there, means 10% blending of ethanol. Brazil has gone to 25%. And 2021-22 is that magic number up to which you even need not to modify any engine or automobile car. So you can at least go up to 20 very easily, and which is the target of the government. But unfortunately, we are not able to even achieve 7% blending of ethanol. So there is a huge potential. Use can be diverted. There is surplus sugar with us. Ball is in our court. We have to decide that instead of this juice, this by sugar route, it should be diverted to ethanol route. At least straight away, government will save 10% forex, because all of the crude oil which we import takes a lot of foreign exchange away. So straight away, there is a saving of foreign exchange to the government. Not only it improves your plant's efficiency, and in the morning session, there was very good discussion wherein this was demanded to our Honorable Minister Tope Saab also, that if we put up a revenue earning model instead of balance sheet by which these loans can be given to the factories for setting up their ethanol facility, it will be great. So I am pretty sure he will do his bit, and we will also try to push PMO and Petroleum Ministry for this. We are also representing from Sugar Technologies Association. There are some products which we are talking to ethanol, which are already we are making, but we have to add some more products which can be go to the industry. And that is what the requirement is. In Brazil and few countries where there is a 100% business running on ethanol, we also have at least few towns, one town 100%, where in Nagpur, Gadkari Saab has taken this initiative, and there are buses imported from Brazil running with 100% on ethanol. And if you see, I have presented a paper in DSTA, I think 2-3 years back, wherein we put up a smart concept of a sugar factory. And a sugar factory of 5,000, which is the normal size in our country, has a potential to give all city bus, all trucks which are running in the factory for the cane transportation, all vehicles of that factory can run on ethanol, that much is produced from there itself. So there is a huge potential which we only need to exploit. There is another thing which is happening is that we have banned by our government the plastic. Single-use plastic has been banned. And that has been tried in, you know, putting in the roads by tarpaulining the road. And this is a very good initiative. And we will talk that this is also possible from bagasse. So this is in the sugar factory, when in a complex this is being done. The vinasse we are using as an effluent. There is no need of effluent treatment plant, because in India more than 70 boilers running successfully on incineration mode, where we are concentrating the vinasse and burning into the boiler. Not only producing the electricity required for the distillery, but also exporting it. As we already talking since beginning of this presentation, that these are the few products which are already being produced in India, some in the complex, but some are separately by buying molasses from the sugar factories. So if we have these are very profitable and need of lot of industry with a very good price and good margins. So instead of giving economics of each and every one, I can tell you that the revenue which you are earning out of ethanol, it is 1.6 to 1.7 times if you go for these products. CO2 plants, also out of 177 distillery, our observation is that hardly 25% of the factories are having CO2 plants. Whereas CO2 is a very common use thing for the carbonated beverage plant, chemical preparation, use as a fire extinguisher, use as a refrigerant dry ice. So, we have shown that what is the potential per ton, total tonnage per KLPD, means 30 KLPD, how much it can generate per day. And we have to see, tap this revenue in each and every distillery at least what we have. Then bio-CNG is another thing which we are pursuing very hard, and now 5-6 sugar plants are there which are producing it, and they are running successfully and producing this bio-CNG. There is a huge potential that from 1 ton of cake you can produce around 30 kg of bio-CNG. And wherever, now in future is bio-CNG, in Delhi there is hardly any commercial vehicle which runs on petrol or diesel. All vehicles are running bio-CNG. Autos, buses, all public transport system is on. Government run all vehicles of public transport is through bio-CNG. So these bio-CNG pipelines are spreading, and there is a program of government to spread in B-class cities. There are 150 smart cities which has been identified already by the government, where they want by 2023, by piping system, the gas will reach over there, and they will also have the petrol pumps, I mean gasoline gas pumps, so where bio-CNG will be available. So if factory starts gearing up now, then only within 2-3 years they will also be producing bio-CNG, and they can directly tap to these pipelines, and by metering they can be paid. So instead of buying 1.8, 1.9 crores single kit, the skid which comes on a truck by which you can transport bio-CNG today also, that is little bit expensive. So if you can directly tap through pipe near you, then it will be better, like we are doing in cogeneration. Wherever the substation is near, 10 kilometers, 7 kilometers, 20 kilometers, we are tapping the line and going over there. The processing is also not a rocket science, fairly easy. There is a digester in which you can put, I have done my fellowship on this subject. wherein you can mix the press mud with various kind of combination. Like cow dung, slop of the distillery, and effluent of the factory, and we found that in most of these, it is giving good result. And even cow dung, gobar jise kehte hain. So cow dung is a very easy source, and almost all factories are in rural area, and very easily available. If it is mixed with that, the biogas concentration is best, and washing of that gas is very easy because there is not much sulfides and H2S etc. in that, and then you are compressing it and sending it. So it's a very safe and good process, not very expensive. Similarly, bagasse also has a huge potential, and from all platforms, at least I am warning to all sugar factories since last 2 years, that kindly forget about cogeneration. Although my company's business is, we have supplied more than 700, 800 boilers all over the world, but still, as a president of STI, I will say that after 5 years, nobody is going to buy your electricity. So kindly think of alternative use of bagasse, because the energy source, you cannot compete with the energy where there is no OPEX, zero OPEX. Solar plant, well, there is nothing. What fuel they want? Nothing. So there is no cost. And they can compete at as low as 2 rupees and 2 rupees 20 paisa per unit. But biomass factories cannot do. Although we are talking to government that biomass energy should be paid extra, and there, on this subject we have done the representation, but still we have to prepare ourselves when alternates are there which can give you more revenue. Why not to go on that? We all know it's a cellulose rich thing. We have to separate lignin. We can go for the 2G ethanol also. Bioplastic is possible. So anything which has carbon, and it has carbon in abundance, which can make this, and this is a biodegradable plastic which is very healthy, and you can bury in the soil and within 3 weeks it gets biodegraded. So you can see from this that although we are on a very high bar pressure operating in most of the factories, 110, 125 bar, out of 177, almost 80% of the factories having this pressure, and the potential of power per megawatt or per ton of bagasse also increases. So it is wise to have a high pressure boiler. And in India, most of the factories in Maharashtra, Senapati, Ghorpade, Daun, there are several factories who have achieved 140 kilowatt power per ton of cane, which means 25 to 30 kilowatt for the campus and sugar production, and 110, 108, 112 kilowatt per ton of sugar cane they are selling to the grid. The eco-friendly bioplastic is also made, and I have seen some plants, one plant in Mexico also for Coca-Cola, which is making these bottles for the Coca-Cola. So there are huge consumption source, and if this biodegradable plastic we make, then it is very healthy, and probably revenue stream will be much better than our electricity one, cogeneration one. I already explained to you that it's not toxic, it is more sustainable, and it has a eco-friendly nature. So by this, we can give almost 525 means almost every town has a sugar mill. And if a factory takes care of the surrounding, then plastic is available for that town. Second generation ethanol. We know today, although viability is not there, but there is a plant in Parasikaba who is running since years. There is so many plants in India, HPCL, IOCL, they have already initiated to set up 4 such plants, and they are very huge capacity plants. We also have two R&D plants which are running in India and making 2G ethanol. So this is the future, and we all know that when this solar system came, it was roughly around 1.5 lakhs rupees per kilowatt. Now today it is, you know, less than 30,000 rupees per kilowatt. So we know that slowly, slowly the engineering cost, which is very high at this moment in this and which makes it unviable, those engineering cost and chemical cost will come down, and then this will also become a viable technology in a due course. So this is, we explained how it is being done. The bagasse in apparel industry. Japan is the one country which is using and making a very, very nice clothing and jeans, etc. out of this bagasse, because it has a lot of viscose in it, like lyocell is there. So this is one good thing which we can think of. It is shredded and broken down in eco-friendly chemicals or other chemicals, and when it is still in liquid form, it is shot at a very high pressure through tinny holes, and long strand of fibers then solidify, and that can be spun into the air. So this is much better cloth, much glossier, and looks like silk, silky finish, and denim finish, two kind of finish it can have. And these are the actual photographs of the these clothes and fibers which are made out of this bagasse. And Japan, they are writing it, it is from the cane fiber. Then paper industry, there is a you know, company called Chemical System who is making in Delhi these cutleries, and they are very popular into the, you know, picnics and other normal kind of places where they use it. The bags are being made out of this. Then furfural is another thing which was tried in few factories in India, and then because cogeneration was very remunerative, not because furfural is a failed technology or it cannot be produced or it doesn't give a good revenue, but when 6 rupees 50 paisa was the power rate, then furfural was not a, you know, good solution. But if nobody buys, then furfural probably is another good solution to make from the factory, for the factory. So I'm just comparing it quickly, one model. Very quickly I will finish it because I know time is up and you all are hungry. So if a biorefinery is there of 5000 TCD, which use only 4200 TCD for refined sugar and pharma sugar, and 800 for the ethanol direct from juice. And I had given some design of this factory, makes EU grade 2 sugar. And this is a practically running factory. Piprite is one of this factory, which is, you know, first phase is already completed, refined sugar as well as 5000, and now the this ethanol plant for from juice to ethanol is under progress. So I have shown what are the revenues from various stream we will have. I have taken the cane rate is 325 rupees per quintal, means 3250 per ton. And this biorefinery will yield from various source, and then in the end I have summarized that bio-CNG plant, CO2 plant, what revenue you will have, and at the end from this 5000 CCD plant you will have 81.8 crores revenue per year. So if we talk depreciation and all interest and everything, and taking cost of this complex at 355 crores, which includes cost of sugar and cogen, pharmaceutical plant, 60 KLPD distillery, civil cost, cogen, ethanol, CO2 plant, bio-CNG, CO2 plant again, and this 355 with all depreciation and everything, probably 6 years is a return of investment. I mean, straight mathematics says about 4 years, 3 months, but with depreciation and loans, whatever you take is about 6.2 years return of investment. So, in the present scenario, where sugar and cogeneration is not the only viable solution, this presentation gives you some out-of-box thinking on what else can be done and how we can increase our revenue out of the same cane which we have already paid for. Now, 325 we have paid. Now, what we have to see what we can extract out of it. Only sugar and cogen or something else also. Thanks for your hearing.